Now in the name of our loving, liberating, and life-giving God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. From the Song of Solomon in the Bible. Set me as a seal upon your heart, as a seal upon your arm. Love is as strong as death, passion fierce as the grave. It's flashes and flashes of fire, raging flames. Many waters cannot quench love, neither can floods. The New Testament says it this way, beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God, and those who love are born of God and know God. Those who do not love do not know God. Why? For God is love. There's power in love. There's power in love to help and heal when nothing else can. There's power in love to lift up and liberate when nothing else will. You can imagine a world where love is the way. Imagine our homes and families when love is the way. Imagine neighborhoods and communities where love is the way. Imagine governments and nations where love is the way. Imagine business and commerce when love is the way. Imagine this tired old world when love is the way. When love is the way, unselfish, sacrificial, redemptive, when love is the way, then no child will go to bed hungry in this world ever again. When love is the way, we will let justice roll down like a mighty stream and righteousness like an ever-flowing river. When love is the way, poverty will become history. When love is the way, the earth would be a sanctuary. When love is the way, we will lay down our swords and shields down by the riverside to study war. No more. When love is the way, there's plenty good room. Plenty good room for all of God's children. Because when love is the way, we actually treat each other a new earth, a new world, a new human family. When love is the way, we know that God is the source of all, and we are brothers and sisters, children of God. That's a new heaven, a new earth, a new world, a new human family. And let me tell you something. Old Solomon was right in the Old Testament. That's fire. They are they should on. And with this, sit down. We gotta get you all married. Fire, to a great extent, made human civilization possible. Fire made it possible to cook food and to provide sanitary ways of eating, which reduced the spread of disease in its time. Fire made it possible to heat warm environments, and thereby made human migration around the world a possibility, even into cold climates. Fire made it possible. There was no Bronze Age without fire. No Iron Age without fire. No Industrial Revolution without fire. The advances of science and technology are greatly dependent on the human ability and capacity to take fire and use it for human good. Anybody get here in a car today? An automobile? Nod your heads if you did, I'm guessing. I know there were some carriages. But those of us who came on cars, fire, the controlled, harnessed fire, made that possible. I know that the Bible says, and I believe that Jesus walked on the water. But I have to tell you, I didn't walk across the Atlantic Ocean to get here. Controlled fire in that plane got me here. Fire makes it possible for us to text and tweet and email and Instagram and Facebook and socially be dysfunctional with each other. Fire makes all of that possible. And Desjardins said fire was one of the greatest discoveries in all of human history. And he then went on to say that if humanity ever harnesses the energy of fire again, if humanity ever captures the energy of love, it will be the second time in history that we have discovered fire. Dr. King was right. We must discover.